Children, we go ahead to the next topic of your lessons, that is the events that took place between 1922 and 1929. Now, as I told you earlier, Gandhiji had started the non-cooperation movement and he wanted everyone to not to cooperate with the British, but in a non-violent manner. But some group of people misunderstood and turned out to be violent. An incident happened at Chauri Chaura, which is in Uttar Pradesh. The peasants were doing a peaceful demonstrations when the police opened fire on them. And this angered the peasants and they all collectively set fire to a police station, killing 22 policemen that day. Now these policemen were actually Indians who were working for the British Army. And when Gandhiji heard about this violent movement, he was very shocked and he abruptly ended. He said, now from today only I am going to call off the non-cooperation movement. People should learn, and I have already said that it has to be in a peaceful manner, in a non-violent manner, and they have taken action in their hands. So he immediately called off the non-cooperation movement. Children, after the call off of the non-cooperation movement because of the violent incident at Chauri Chaura, Gandhiji stressed that the Congress party now should go into the rural areas and do some constructive work, teach the rural areas how to become self-dependent and influence them to earn money, to grow their own crops, to earn their own living. Okay, but few leaders like Chittaranjan Das and Motilal Nehru said that no, we should also fight for the elections to the Congress so that many Indians can get into the government and influence government policies and tell them that this is what India wants. So some of them should also do it. But many also went in ahead listening to Gandhiji and did a lot of social work. And why Gandhiji wanted now was to collect as many as people, especially from the rural areas, so that they have a more strong base and a united India to fight against the British. So they wanted everyone, including the people in the rural areas, the backwards, to now come up in support for the national movement. Children, during this time period, there were two important developments that led to the formation of two major parties in India. One was the formation of the RSS, that the Rashtriya Swayam Sevak, that is the party which believed in Hindu ideals. And then there was a Communist Party also formed, which believed in socialism, that means everyone should get equal amount of pay, that whatever the wealth is should be equally distributed. So these parties had different ideas of what kind of country India should be after independence. And it's not that only one person contributed to the independence of India. Many people in small way or the other were contributed towards the independence of our country. So a major development was the formation of these two parties, that is the Communist Party of India and the Rashtriya Swayam Sevak, that is the RSS. Okay, but there were other people also who took up violent means of driving the British away. They were called as revolutionary nationalists. Now we look at them. One of them was Bhagat Singh, was very active during this period. Children, we see the rise of many revolutionary nationalists, and one of the most important one was Bhagat Singh. Now he too also wanted to drive the British away from the country, but his ideas were by using force, and with the help of the peasants and workers, he formed a party which was called as the Hindustan Socialist Republic Association. It was HSRA. And he gave his cry as Inqilab Zindabad. He wanted to teach the colonial rule and the rich exploiting classes of the British that they now had to leave the country. So in order to threaten them, along with one of his fellow mates, V. Kedar, they threw a bomb in the Central Legislative Assembly in 1929. And with that, he threw a leaflet with a paper in the Legislative Assembly, and it read, that this bomb is not to kill but to make the deaf hear, to remind the colonial government of how careless it is and what kind of exploitation they are doing to the Indians. And for this, Bhagat Singh was then tried and executed. It means he was hanged to death. So you see, in some ways, not only the major Congress party was into it, but people in their own way also were doing something to fight against the British. So there, all their contribution, we can't say it is only one party or one person. Many people all over India were doing their own bits to drive the British away from the country. Children, by 1929, we see in the Congress, new leaders were emerging, and one of them was Jawaharlal Nehru. And during his time, a Lahore session was held by the Congress party. In that, Jawaharlal Nehru was made the president of the Congress party. And he then at that session declared that he demanded Purna Swaraj. That means now he was not only wanting only Indians in the administration. He wanted complete independence. That means he wanted the Britishers to move out of the country. And on 26 January 1930, he declared it as an Independence Day. And that was celebrated all over the country. Although the Britishers were there, but this was just a mark to show the British that now they will not accept anything else from the British but complete independence. So now Congress was moving ahead under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru. Children, the Britishers, on seeing the national movement gaining momentum, they decided that they must do something for the Indians, otherwise they'll have to leave the country much earlier than they had decided. So in 1927, the British government in England decided to send a commission headed by Lord Simon to decide India's future planning. But in that commission, it was sent for the betterment of India, to improve the condition of the people and gain their support. But in that commission, what is the commission? It is a group of people who decide and formulate plans for the country. But in that commission, it had only British people in it. There were no Indian representatives. Okay, and this, when the Indians heard it, Indian leaders heard it, they were very annoyed that you are deciding something for our country and we don't have Indian representative in it. So all the political parties decided to boycott the commission. So when the commission arrived, it was meant with, it was dealt with demonstrations and banners like Simon, go back. And people protested against this commission. So finally they had to call off this commission. And it is said that during this, demonstrations were made in Punjab, there was a police officer who lathi charged and he hit Lala Lajpat Rai on his head with his lathi. On which Lala Lajpat Rai died. And Bhagat Singh, on seeing this, was very, very annoyed. All the members of his party were annoyed, and they assassinated that police officer Saunders. Okay.